Alrighty, we're going live here. This is Dead Island. Lefty's already here. Hey, Lefty. I'm gonna put this up so we can see when the guy goes live. But I've got a layout ready for that. But in the meantime, I've got some Dead Island up here. Audio mix should be okay. I tried to sort through my audio issues. New PC and components coming Monday should fix that. So thank y'all for coming out. Really appreciate it. It's just going to be full screen game for now. And then when the guy goes live, I will pop out the new layout that I came up with. But we are live, Lefty, so you may pull away. Meanwhile, I'm just gonna poke around, explore, and get the zombies. Alright, so I need to get back outside. Okay, yep, I've got the stuff from that guy already. Lord Thunder, welcome, welcome. It's full screen gameplay for the time being, but I'm ready to go when the guy goes live. I'm playing Dead Island because Dave won't, so it only makes sense, I think. Did I get everything in here? Yeah, I got everything in here. And always get the stuff. Thanks for clocking. Really appreciate it. Let me just make sure the layout is ready. Oh, yes it is. Perfect. We've got Sam Porter Bridges standing watch in Phil's chat already. That's ready to go. Oh, cool. And our chat box is working and I sized it correctly. Awesome. That'll work. That will work. But for now, we can stick with the gameplay. I'm just looting this lady's house. Don't mind me. Ooh, chemicals. A note. Order llama milk? Who drinks llama milk? Hippy dippy granola munchers, man. Okay, Dave turned his stupid music on. So I'm gonna mute his ass, and then we're gonna go over to this, and then this. And then got to make sure we're watching the live feed. Okay, cool. So the split is up and running. We can watch that until Dave actually goes live. Hey, Tryon. Good to see you, buddy. I hope everyone is having a solid day today. Let's go and explore. This game is good, at least in my opinion it is. Wait, now it's telling me to go back in the house. What's my actual objective? Call the cavalry. Tell the authorities you're immune. Okay. And I do that in the house. How? Okay, so basement? Oh, it wants me to go out the back gate. Okay. Green Mountain Time. Thank you for clocking in, Green Mountain Time. Appreciate it. This game's cool. The dismemberment stuff, if you can get it to go, is real cool. Ah, quakes! Fuck! Okay, watch out for falling power lines. Alright, I'm gonna kite him over here. He'll get shocked. There we go. You can do a lot of cool environmental shit in here. Okay, so I can take the car battery when we're ready to go. But I'll do this. Oh, I missed that kick. Alright, I'm getting swarmed. Getting swarmed. Fuck! All these zombie cops, man! I'm getting mobbed. Zombie cop's gonna take me! Come on, fucking cop. Yeah! Alright, cool. I don't think I was supposed to take out that entire mob that way. But it's done and it worked. Okay, so I'm gonna use some meat bait to lure these guys in here. And this should solve some of the problem for me. Okay, shocked that lady. I'm gonna see if I can take out this dude's legs. Get him. Yeah! See, this game's cool! Phil should be playing this game. This game is alright. I played it with a friend of mine yesterday, and we had a lot of fucking fun. Epic achievements. Yes, yes, I will never look at that achievement list. Get off me, lady. Yeah, this layout works pretty good. Awesome. Exactly, the difference is I have people that want to play with me. Exactly. Because I bother to, like, seek out people to play games with. I have burnt some bridges in my life, but I have not burnt every bridge. I've kept some. I've been an asshole to a lot of people, but, I have some people that still care about me, so. But this game's cool, man. I don't know what he was expecting. This is a zombie loot game, just like the other one was. He needs his- well, he needs one of his boyfriends, specifically Green Mountain Time. He needs John Rambo. And, John Rambo smelled the fucking coffee and got out. I wonder, can I damage this? I don't want to waste my awesome, can I damage this? Yes. Oh god! Oh god! That's brutal! I'll do this like all day. I'll just keep stabbing zombies in the eyes. This knife's pretty weak. Oh no! I'm getting chomped on! No! There we go. All because I wanted this. Hell fucking yeah. This is sweet. Well, I got an uncommon weapon out of that. That's not bad. I agree, Green Mountain Time. The people... Well, yeah. If you stay with people like Phil, they will only bring you down. I think John realized that. I think Howard knew he was, to use a British term, I think Howard knew he was a bit of a wanker from the very beginning. But I think Howard thought that Project 7 was a cool thing they could all participate in. And he was kind of right. But, I think, it did way more harm to all of them than good. I'd be interested to know where the Respect the Pack guys are today. BST, how are you? Okay, so I got a battery, gas can. Oh, what's this house? Look at all these cars, man. Alright, actually, I'll hang on to this battery. I might be able to use it for something.
Uh-huh. Shortcut this way.
Oh, we got a streamer house. Look, we got a DSLR. It's a streamer house. Actually, the first lady that you rescue in this game is some kind of movie star or streamer. I don't know. She's got like 5 streaming setups. I was critiquing them on my personal channel. Yeah, a bit of a knob. Correct.
Locked. We're doing it the hard way.
Oh, I can hit this guy with the battery. That's fun. All right, gotta find a way in. I don't want to use that because it's way OP. I'll use this sword instead. Can I bust this? Yes. Okay. So that's my way in, but I want to see if there's anything up here I can get. Thank you, BST. Appreciate that. I'm just glad people are hanging out today. We're gonna do a poor man's raid like we always do, and we'll send you. I'll link you back to the Decepticron. Holy shit! Look at this setup. They've got like a full. Yeah, these are studio cameras. They've got tally lights. Teleprompter? No, teleprompter nowhere to be found. But yeah, those are studio cameras. So wonder who lives here. All right, let's just get in. Slice you in the butt. Oh, the butt slice was effective. Get off me. You asshole. I got stuck in block. Because I'm a controller pleb. My new keyboard should be here today. So when I get my new keyboard, I'm actually going to go back to mouse and keyboard again. Yes, Lefty! John, I love how John's life immediately improved. Like, almost immediately. Like, that same year, he was getting awards at film festivals, and his Schnozman and Hole Punch series was doing awesome. The correlation is, like, unmistakable. Like, you can't miss it. Almost immediately when Phil moved away and they stopped talking, John's life became amazing. I also like the little bit of lore that DSP admitted himself that he deleted John's fucking number so he couldn't drunk text him anymore. Man, these animations are fun. Like, yeah, maybe this is a carbon copy of the first game, but like, these animations are pretty fun. Can't deny that. I feel like I'm doing damage to these zombies and it's very cool. Yeah, Reap, I'm using a controller, but like I just mentioned a minute ago, I'm getting a new Logitech mechanical keyboard today. It should be coming in the mail. So I will transition to mouse and keyboard post-haste once I have that thing on my person, in my possession. Oh, pool zombies. Are you alive? Yeah, you're alive. Oh, her gut jiggles. They got gut jiggle physics. Yeah, dude, that's actually pretty cool. Wait, what the fuck is that Resident Evil still right there? That's the first time I saw that one. That one is dog shit. These zombies are kind of spongy. It's alright if you practice good. Oh, she came out of the vent. Fuck you. Fuck you, man. Yeah, drunk dialer Dave, dude. I can imagine. I can imagine John and Howard talking, and John's like, "Yeah, dude, he texted me again," and Howard's probably like, "That motherfucker." I can't do a good Howard impersonation. Tevin did a great one. I guess you just have to yell a lot, but I could just imagine Howard be like, "That motherfucker, no respect."
Another key card? Is this a rich person thing?
Okay, I gotta steal a key card. From the goat pen? They have a goat. Is that a nickname? That might be someone's nickname. I'll just kick this dude forever. Alright, broke that. Switch to my stabby weapon. Oh yeah, this is a fucking streamer house. Blown my house at 1 a.m. Sorry for my fans, I've disappointed. Cry here for sympathy. Scripted was... Phil needs this! He needs an apology script. He needs an apology script to the world. Which one did I buy? I ordered it a week or so ago. I forgot the exact model, but I ordered like kind of like a mid-tier one. I didn't want to spend too much money because I had one, but I got a little too excited during a Hitman stream like 3 or 4 months ago, and I spilled water on it during a Hitman stream, and it never worked again. So my own fault. Dude, look at this fucking setup. Dude. Get profit in here. That's like a... What is that? Like a blue Yeti? Knockoff? DSLR. Those look like Corsair knockoffs. That looks like a Logitech knockoff keyboard and a Logitech... Yeah, this is a fucking streamer setup. And they're playing music from an amp. Huh. Okay. Yeah, I figured it was like a Logitech something. It's cool to go through all these like Beverly Hills houses. Okay, so it's not here, must be downstairs. It's a lot of searching in this game. It's probably in the basement. If I remember my Dead Island games, a lot of the stuff you search for, you find it on a body in a basement. Yeah, and it's below us. Oh, I overshot that person for the... Ah, the jump kick is finicky. Yep, keep overshooting this lady. Okay, so that's the gate. Or did I randomly pick it up? Yeah, I did. I randomly picked it up while I was looting. I'm just gonna leave these guys alone. The guy is not live yet. Multiple kicks to the leg seems to be the way to go. Okay, we've got water, we've got gas. Got a car alarm.
Back on track for this hotel.
It's kind of goofy how many times you have to stab people. I'm gonna take this battery. Can I? Oh, I can electrify blood. Sweet, dude. That's awesome. That's so cool that I could electrify the blood with the battery. Yeah, Sadie, I agree. There's like a cleanliness and a shine to these graphics that are very cyberpunk-like. I've always liked the idea of like a bright, vibrant zombie game. There aren't enough of those. Like, I like Left 4 Dead as much as the next guy, but I like how weird and bright this game is.
Hi, I'm
God. I'm having a lot of fucking fun with it.
Perfecto. Just gotta find the help.
Oh, shuriken. Sweet, dude. Crimson electric. Exactly.
Ay, the soldiers at the Halperin better not be infected, too.
Oh, dude, this thing is goated. See how I just took out that dude's legs? Holy shit. Alright. The pipe wrench is now the MVP of this game for me, right now. Holy fucking shit. Okay, can't get in that way. I'll take this gas can. I don't have anything to spark it with. Maybe I can find a battery? No, too late. Oh, you can maintain your charge while you're blocking. That's nice. This thing hits so heavy. Good lord. I didn't mind the base building in Fallout 4. I just think glue was hard to find. I remember glue being really rare. Glue and screws were really rare and annoying to find. You had to find those alarm clocks, dude. The alarm clocks were everything and everywhere. See, I feel like I'm in a fucking Robert Rodriguez movie right now. If you ever watched that Netflix movie, Army of the Dead, really fucking cool. You gonna hit me? This reminds me a lot of Army of the Dead. Really cool movie with Dave Bautista. Okay, that bus is electrified. Oh! Oh man, I got stealthed by a cop zombie. Get out of here. All right. How are you not dead? Okay, the guy is going live-ish, so I'm gonna pause the game, and I want to make sure his audio is okay. Except we're not gonna watch this this Andy Dick thing. Nope. But we'll full screen him, and then we'll press unmute as soon as this is over, and I just want to make sure his audio is okay. Oh, fuck you, Andy Dick. All right, I'm gonna watch the monitors for a sec.
Good. Good morning, everyone. Phil here, and welcome to...
All right, that should be a good mix. Pahdcahst.
We're busy having fun down here on Level 1. Today is Saturday, the 22nd of April, 2023, and that's
what... Oh, New Vegas is so good.
You know what that means? It means that today, completely misspeaking, is React Day. It is our...
React!
We take out a major stream to head on over to DSP React for my weekly Clips Reaction show that is called... DSP versus the Internet. That's right. It is on Saturdays that members over on my sister channel
nominate
videos for me to react to.
I've got water valves.
Interesting time.
I need to shoot up.
Sometimes there's
there we go.
Really great videos. Sometimes there's not so great videos, but...
Oh, it's the Shining Twins.
The fun of it is that you never know what I'm going to watch. It could be things that are very similar. It could be things that are completely different. It could be
something... I got spanked. Okay.
You know, another version or maybe a follow-up. It could be something completely new and off.
I enjoy the reacts, so I'm not gonna. I usually watch the Decepticon, but I'm gonna take a break. I need a Phil's. I need a Phil's detox today.
It'll be a good show over there. All right.
So I think after this pre-stream, I'm gonna watch one of the John Wick movies. If anybody wants to join me, I'm gonna be hanging out in one of the chat channels on the Detractor Beam Discord watching that. Probably John Wick 1, actually. I was thinking John Wick 1 or Mad Max Fury Road. Either one.
We also have,
but I can't take any more Phil.
Discussion I want to have with you.
I do not have a high tolerance for him right now.
Something that I did on the React channel about a week ago that went really well. People really seem to enjoy it.
Yeah, the Candy Stripers fucking wrecked me. Yeah, they did.
How often...
Oh, they were Candy Stripers. That's what they were. Duh.
And how should I go about it? So today we're going to talk about Tier Maker.
Okay? Oh my God.
That as well as a segment.
Thank you, Thunder.
And then, of course, the usuals.
My audio's been really fucked up lately, so I wanted to come out swinging on this stream to fix a lot of that shit. Some of the capacitors on my motherboard, I think, are about to pop, which is why my audio is, like, really inconsistent stream to stream. But, new PC, tomorrow. New PC on Monday, actually. Thanks to Profit. Tonight, Profit gave me good advice on a new PC, so streaming should be easier and a lot more consistent. How'd I miss that button press? So basic.
Interaction. Talking with each other about the game, about the improvements in this version of the game. Really enjoying the music and some of the quality of life stuff that's been added in the game, being widescreen and everything. In fact,
this game is so fucking good. It's just fun smacking zombies, and maybe that's enough. For me, that's enough. It's not going to be enough for everybody, and I realize it, but I'm having a lot of fun. Just whacking zombies in the head, like that. Stunk.
There's a way to access, like, the full world map from the main menu, and the game doesn't really tell you that.
Like that. That's fucking fun, dude. That's cool.
A speeding up in battle, like, let's say for example you're fighting really weak level enemies
and there's a lady with a prosthetic leg who, when you do the kick, with her, she kicks with her prosthetic leg, and that's a lot of fun.
I want to say thanks to anyone who's been leaving comments.
I keep dying
so far or following up, like, I got
so new PC based on Profit's advice. I got, for the GPU, I got a 4070 Ti. He told me to go with that versus a 4080. I got a Core i9, a 16-core processor, 32 gigs of RAM, a bunch of SSDs. It should be very good for streaming. And I believe the video card has dual video encoding, so I should get better. I should be able to run games on higher settings with background removers and shit, so I'm really excited about it. It's a good system. Profit advised me on it. He gave me his blessing, so.
You know, here's the thing. I think Tier Maker worked really, really well. The other night, if it was Monday night, we did a random Tier Maker stream, and it ended up being the best fast food franchises in the U.S. And it was a two-hour show. And we
a DSP stream being about a DSP stream. Basically. Very meaningful content.
Why I ranked them the way I did. People really seemed to
like... No one cares.
Is actually the most viewed video.
I know, Lefty. My PC is leveling up, like, massively as of Monday. I don't know if I'll have time to get it up and running until maybe the following weekend, but, like, I'm excited. We can do a lot of cool game night shit on it. I already have some ideas.
have.
I know you and I have been talking about carrier command forever.
Yeah, so that
it'd be really cool to get like split screen so carrier command today, with not only two screens but like three or four. Is the dream. Climbing. So we'll have to figure out how to do that.
That is the most viewed video that I've uploaded on that channel in about 2 to 3 months.
No one cares about your view audits, dude.
So that's awesome. You know, that's really cool. That it got that much
positive. Your content is dog shit because your content is about itself. It's the most human centipede content on the internet. It's a copy of a copy of a copy of a copy.
You guys in the chat, because you guys definitely helped me with those rankings to establish how they should be. Because people were like, what? Don't put it that high. Don't do it that low. Here's why. And then, oh, you know what? You're right. And then I would readjust the ranking or whatever. People really seem to like that. So I like that. That's a good show. I think that's good tier making.
Oh, Riot Gearwalker. Okay.
Every once in a while for a variety kind of a deal. I don't think an entire day of tier maker would work. Why?
Oh, good point. Good point, Dog Explained. The backstabbed one got a very high number of views.
There was no break.
Oh, crowbar. Fuck yeah.
There was no break. I couldn't even stop talking and
kill them all.
My voice was shocked. At the end of that night, I was physically exhausted from talking 2.5 straight hours. That's number one.
I have this goaded electric sword.
I tried to do an entire day of talking to your maker like that. It would probably be like, I would be so exhausted. I would probably lose my
voice. Dude, you fucked up your voice in so many ways right now.
Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney for the first time, and I did all the voice acting for the game, remember? And how I lost my voice for about a week when I did so. I would predict that would probably happen again.
Another candy. Actually, it looks like a girl going for prom, actually. That's what it looks like.
I don't think that an entire day of it is practical. That's number one. However, doing it as a part of a marathon. Like,
all right, I need my heavy fucking hitter.
One or two tier maker rankings that would last
like that?
2 hours. That's different. That could definitely work. Number two, I do feel that if I do tier maker too much, that it's going to end up being not special anymore. Now, listen,
dude,
I like
you do reacts too much.
Really like it.
You actually do reacts too much.
The more commonplace it becomes, and it doesn't feel as interesting or special anymore. With the tier maker stuff, maybe I would like to do it at most.
Okay, I survived. Barely.
At most. Okay? But even then, that could be kind of excessive.
Good point, Sadie. He removes all of the reason you'd watch a tier maker video. He has no one to bounce ideas off of, no one to debate with.
But on a week where we've got,
we had more fun in the Detractor Beam Discord shitting on his tier maker than he had entertaining his actual audience.
Address this further in a minute or two, because we're going to continue with the schedule right now, and I'd like to talk to you guys about what you would like to see for the late night streams the rest of this week, and this is going to come into play. Fair enough. So,
fair enough.
It is
correct.
One podcast here on DSP Gaming. Then we head over to DSP React, where members have nominated clips.
Okay, so it seems like after fights, your health restores to a certain level.
And then when that's done,
so I just need to be careful. Ooh, soda.
And
yes.
Tonight, excuse me. Ooh, excuse me. Tonight on DSP Gaming, it's Final Fantasy V Pixel Remaster continuing.
Which no one wants and no one cares about.
So a great day of content all over my channel. Right?
Oh my god, I could have used the jerry can to fuck
Sunday,
these guys up. Whatever.
Full-time
you live and you learn.
DSP Gaming. The first stream will be Elden Ring. Now, Elden Ring's been really interesting.
Raziel the Lost with total fire. Everything he does is special, but not for the reason he thinks. You're correct. I agree with you.
And then we headed over to Caelid. And in Caelid, I beat multiple optional bosses, such as the Deathbird, and there was also Captain O'Neill, and we actually started up the Millicent quest line. So we
okay,
did
seems
stuff.
Like I'm pretty well set up with the loot that was out here.
Underground into the well in
so I'll head in.
Grave, because that's where the Blade quest line starts. And I think we'll do the well first, and then after that we'll probably go to the town, the magical town of Celia, and clear out that town and do the magical bosses and things there. And then see how much time we have left, okay? So that's probably tomorrow's Elden Ring Magic Build stream. Tomorrow night on the late stream, it will be more Elder Scrolls 4 Oblivion. And I have an update on that.
No one calls it Elder Scrolls 4 Oblivion. No one calls it that.
So last night, on my Oblivion stream, we finished up the Mage's Guild questline, and then we were basically checking in on...
All right, if I had a spark, I could light these guys on fire, but I don't.
So we ended up doing, you know, one...
All right, I'm gonna kite them out.
Quests for about a half an hour. It's not...
And
yet,
we'll do some...
We got into a big...
We'll do some crowd control.
What should I do for the...
Oh, no, you know what? You know what I can do?
My Elden Ring playthrough, right? Should it be... Elden Ring, excuse me. The future of my Oblivion playthrough. Should it be that... Since I've now been playing this for 4 months, and we're 60 hours in, should I look to start wrapping it up and have other late-night chill stream content?
Late-night chill stream content. That is, like, the most buzzwords I've heard.
Discussion about it last night. There's definitely pros and cons. You know, some people are of the impression, yeah, you played it for 4 months, we want to see variety. But then what we actually did is we took a moment to look at my other recent Bethesda playthrough. My Fallout New Vegas playthrough was 90...
Oh, now we're getting playthrough audits. Fuck you, Phil. Content.
My...
Your stream is eating itself, my dude.
Last year, okay? Started in January, and get this...
Alright, I need to retreat.
All the way through the end of June. It was an
actual... I almost got these guys.
...month-long playthrough. And guess how long okay. the Skyrim playthrough was, including the main game and all DLCs. Ready? 140 hours. Yeah. My Skyrim playthrough was absolutely...
He's acting like he didn't know what he signed out, what he signed up for. With a Bethesda game.
If you remember, Skyrim was very popular.
He's such an asshole.
When I started playing it, and we actually did it as daytime streams for a while. So when I was doing it 2-3 times a week at 3-hour segments, you know, within the first few weeks we were burning through like 40.
Okay, so finally ignited. Okay.
Reached, you know, the 40,
that's what I should have done.
In,
okay.
Know, 2-3 months tops, and then we were like turboing through, but then it became...
I got a safety deposit box key.
Came out. So, essentially we played...
Oh nice, I got metal cats, metal parts, cash and scraps.
A late night chill stream game. In fact, we tried Oblivion as a daytime
PCBs.
Stream. It didn't work. People didn't show up for it and actually complained and were like, "No, we prefer it as the late night stream. Can you put it back to that slot?" So I did. And so that's, I think, what we're going to continue to do. But the question was...
Save times 20 with lockpicking. Yes!
Let's say we wrap...
Oh my god, the lock... Lefty, man, I don't know how you tolerate Oblivion so much. I did that one stream. I think it was the first stream we ever did. I did that one stream with you. And like, that was my limit for Oblivion.
Apparently, Oblivion has multiple DLCs, but the best one and the one...
I just can't watch him play Oblivion.
...is called Shivering Isles. Okay.
Everyone knows what Shivering Isles is, Phil.
At any length, this is my first actual lengthy full playthrough. And after discussing it with the chat, we looked it up. It was $9 for the DLC. I said, all right, you know what? Since you guys have been asking for, especially the more, you know...
This amount of deliberation over $9 fucking dollars, dude.
I don't know if it's actually...
It's sad. It's sad. You don't have $9? Just buy it.
When we play it again.
Well, that's a dumb question, because we all know he has $9.
Okay?
Like, he does.
Likely what'll happen is tomorrow, when I play Oblivion, tomorrow night, Sunday night, which is why we're talking about this, we'll finish up the quest line I'm doing, and then if you guys want, we might just jump right into the Shivering Isles DLC. See, I don't know how it activates, because I never played this game before, but I'm sure people will be there to help and explain.
Fuck, dog-splained. Yes, it is older than most of his audience.
Story, it's about
2008, I think, it came out in.
If you do side content and additional stuff there, it could be up to 30 hours.
So, oh, you can kill him in the acid.
So we,
that's cool.
The Shivering Isles DLC could extend the playthrough about a month to a month and
I'll
a
just
half.
Kick these guys into the pool. I'll just cheese
we're
it.
We're playing it in 2-hour increments. We're playing it 2-3 times a week. It could definitely extend the length of the playthrough significantly. So, I guess we'll see what happens. And it looks
okay,
like
I got random slow-mo for that.
For the foreseeable future.
There's and cash in the acid, but I don't want to...
Okay, so Sunday night is the next...
Oh, I need to investigate the pool. Okay.
Potential start of the Shivering Isles DLC. Alright? Okay. Then on Monday, it's going to be...
Oh my god, Snake Plissken, exactly! You know, that's why I hate when he's, like, squabbling over, like, a $9 thing or a $20 thing. You're gonna chart... If he hits the glasses goal once, it's worth it. He's made money if he hits the fucking glasses goal once.
Fast travel, or should we go through the mines?
He plays poor, but, like, the numbers are not hard to figure out.
Which I just got the ability to use because I have the stats for it. So I basically need to kind of grind a bit of runes or grace, whatever the hell it's called in that game. I don't even remember. But I need to grind for that to try to level up the sword a bit to make it more powerful. So it should be a good time. Now, Monday night, we'll do more Final Fantasy V.
Oh, I fell in. Okay? Don't fall in.
Now, the real question is Tuesday, my final consecutive streaming day of the week. What are we going
to do? Final consecutive streaming day of the week. Boom.
The first stream, I still think I want to do Elden Ring. Now, you might say, wait a minute. You're going to do three straight days of Elden Ring. Isn't it going to get boring? And isn't that too much? Why are you doing
it? It is going to get boring. His audience is right.
There's good reason. Okay? First of all, I'm in a part of the game now where, since I have this magic build...
Exactly. He plays stupid, Sadie, on so many levels. He really does. And that's what infuriates me. He doesn't understand why, like, a 70-hour game is not good for him when he's struggling to finish, like, 20 and 30-hour games now. It's really stupid.
The intelligence build that I'm using, and balance that with magic,
and
on a situation instead of just being ranged. Now
I think I need one more clue.
Okay. So that's good. We're at the precipice of a time that if I play more,
I'm investigating the hotel pool.
Okay. Sound good?
I need sound good. No, it doesn't.
So that's number one. Number two.
It's nice to restock on supplies, though.
Okay. There's going to be a lot going on, including me checking out the Street Fighter VI single player beta. There's a single player beta. Well, I guess it's demo. The single player demo, all right, is coming out on Wednesday for Xbox consoles. And I want to try that out, so I'm going to play that as my major stream on Thursday.
Thanks for the full midlife. Appreciate it.
Single player demo. And then on Friday, it's the release of Star Wars Jedi Survivor, the sequel to Star Wars Jedi Fallen Outcast from many years ago. It's a great game. You know, the first one was really good. It was kind of a hybrid of Dark Souls and other action-adventure with Star Wars. And this game is shaping up to be great. And that starts Friday. Also this weekend, not this weekend, obviously, but next weekend, I should say.
Wait, hold on.
We got my special
so
event. My
Jedi Fallen Order is going to be very similar, or Jedi Fallen Survivor is going to be very similar to Jedi Fallen Order. It's going to be similar, but an improvement. That's what this game is. Dead Island 2 is very similar to Dead Island 1 with many improvements, and he was shitting on this hard. And now he's going to dick ride Fallen Order. What's wrong with you, Phil? He makes no sense.
Fallout 76 and how bad it is. So that's interesting. Maybe I'd really enjoy watching that one. But
I need to find one more clue.
Historian has many good videos, and
I need to find a fuse box to put in here. That's probably where I need to be.
You know, we still have Sunday, Monday, Tuesday.
What's that?
Here on the podcast, we'll actually go to the Internet Historian channel and we'll look
at
videos.
Okay, that needs a key.
Want to see me watch most, or maybe even formulate a poll that you guys can vote.
Oh my God! Not another poll.
Which ones you want me to react on in that long?
Not another poll, dude.
That is 1 week from tomorrow, just so everyone knows. So here's the thing. Why am I playing Elden Ring 3 days this week? Because Thursday I'm doing Street Fighter 6, Friday is Star Wars, Saturday is...
I need to poor shame some people.
Event,
now, guys.
I'm definitely playing more Star Wars. So if you don't see my...
Oh, wait.
Here,
red box. Red
Ring
box up there. Those red boxes
Seriously,
have cool drops
like
in them.
I'm probably not playing it at all. So because of that...
Oh,
I want
nice.
To do a lot of...
Uncommon Hammer. I'm going to switch to that, actually.
To do it before it kind of goes on a mini hiatus for the stuff going on next week.
I'm going to swap...
So that's the point.
Yes.
That's why I'm doing it.
Yes.
So hope that you guys will enjoy. Hope that you guys will join me over the course of this week. And if you like Elden Ring, you're going to have a good time for the next 3 days because Sunday, Monday, Tuesday should be a great treat. Almost 10 hours of gameplay and good advancement. And hopefully Moonveil now will be unlocked and usable. And we'll be kicking some butt in some of the optional content. In the
that's
game.
Right. Okay. I voluntarily Stop. Jumped in the acid. I need one more clue. Where's the goddamn clue?
Radon. Oh. 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 Who said that?
I'm probably, like, walking right past it. Or I just need to find a fuse box.
That the Jedi Survivor file size is huge, 140 gigs on Xbox.
140 gigs? Holy shit.
Trust me, I have more than enough room on my Xbox. I should be good to go. Okay.
Yeah, because you rage delete games, dude.
Now, keep in mind, in the month of May, there's some good stuff coming up. There's Redfall. There's Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom. I believe that there's a new Amnesia.
I'm assuming it has to do with these hoses. I'm just going to follow these hoses around.
There's just a lot of stuff going on. And it should be a good time.
Oh, yeah, there we go.
It should be a good time because of all the new releases that will be balanced with everything else that we're doing. Keep in mind, we could still do Elden Ring. We could do other things, all right? There's a good balance of stuff. That's
shooting up.
This month. So, or this next month, I should say. So I am excited because unlike April, well, let's be honest.
Oh yeah, he's a total pushover.
Remake. and that was about it. Right? Scale releases this month. I mean, Final Fantasy Pixel Remaster is all well and good. I'm going to enjoy it, but that's definitely not a giant release or whatever.
Bonk.
You know, all the other releases were underwhelming, and I'm not playing them.
I like hammers.
For March, I mean,
hammers are good in this game.
At least we're going to have a good amount, a good variety of newer, bigger release schedule games. And the other thing is that's
oh my god, I love where the soundtrack is going right now. The soundtrack is so much fun.
So once we hit May, we're going to be very busy. Put it down. Okay. What's going on, Jade? It's good to see you today. Welcome.
What's going on, Jade? Are you feeling better?
Stuff, all right, everyone.
Jade.
Good stuff. I'm excited, obviously, for, you know, the coming week. I'm excited for the coming month. Everything is stacking up to be pretty entertaining around here. Okay. I also have an update.
I like how he has to call it entertaining for it to be entertaining.
Watching.
That's what I hate.
Harry Potter movie.
It's entertaining because he tells you. It's like his. It's like that defense he used about like what the trolls say about him. He says nothing. I say nothing they say about me is true because I know it's not true. He does the same thing when he's like, "Yeah, I have entertaining, meaningful content on this channel," and it's like, "Well, no, you don't, because you're the only one saying it's entertaining."
Now I have an opportunity to kind of tell you my overall thoughts, not only about the movies, but even
I have an uncle that's a bartender in North Jersey who is very much like DSP. And what my dad says all the time, he says, "Your Uncle Greg is the best bartender in North Jersey. Just ask him." Because he's such a DSP about everything. He'll tell you he's the best bartender in North Jersey because he tells you he's the best bartender in North Jersey, you know? Oh, her wallet fell out of her pocket while she was flying. That was fun.
Hogwarts, which I'd really enjoyed, and this actually was, you know, it was kind of like the exact right time to do it. You know what I'm saying? So, I think it's going to be a great video. I hope you'll check that out. When will that come out? That I can't promise. It'll probably end up being like, definitely this week. I just don't know when. Maybe Sunday night, maybe Monday night. One of these nights, when I get some extra time after my late night stream, I will film and release that video for you over on DSP Reacts. Okay, so that is coming. Now, one other thing that
you don't know when you don't know when you can press publish on a video, Phil.
So it's Elden Ring on Sunday with Oblivion at night. It's Elden Ring on Monday with Final Fantasy V at night. But now we're talking about the future of Tier Maker and the Tier Maker streams, correct? You guys really liked the one I did last Monday, right? Would you like to see another one right
again
away?
You liked the Tier Maker because I said you like it. You know, I hate the way he talks.
That maybe it would be too soon. I don't know. Maybe not. If I'm gonna do
yes, this is a workbench. Let's get to work.
Okay, it's a maybe. If you guys want to see another Tier Maker stream, it'll be this Tuesday night. What will the subject matter be?
Let's upgrade the crowbar.
I think what I might do is formulate another poll.
Shock mod.
You guys have previously suggested, and have you vote on it? All right. But I guess the real question is,
okay, we're like missing that. Okay, so we upgraded that.
Or should we just do an extra?
Let's upgrade this if we can. Upgraded rake.
Really
nope.
We're doing
we don't have the parts for it. That's okay.
I'd be down to do it again on Tuesday night. Okay. So think about it. Let's think about it for about a day or two. Let's all talk about it on the streams, and determine would you prefer to see Final Fantasy V again on Tuesday night, or would you prefer a Tier Maker stream? All right.
Just program your own content, dude. Like, just decide what you're going to do and stream it.
Tier Maker, we'll do a poll. And if we're not going to do Tier Maker, then we'll just chill and we'll do Final Fantasy.
Yes, Thunder. That makes me so upset when he's like, "I'm so busy all the time, guys." But then he's like, "Oh, we have time to do something, but I don't know what it is." Like, dude, you're not busy. Everyone knows you're not busy because you're constantly...
Keep things fresh.
You're constantly asking your audience what you should do with your time. You're not busy.
Talk about, and then we're probably going to get to shoutouts and the like. Is
shoutouts
in the month of May? We need to do some kind of a special event here on DSP Gaming. You know, every month we've been doing one. For February, we did the Super Bowl event, if you remember. And then very early April.
Oh, that's really nice. The electricity ignites his grenades.
There's many options that people have been kind of thinking of. One
and then he blows up. That's awesome.
Event, which is what I kind of wanted to do.
Oh, it's a beer garden.
Marchish, but we didn't do it.
People got married here.
The thing is, we don't have monthly goals anymore. Okay?
You hate to see it.
Do an event. It could be me playing
marriage during an apocalypse. You hate to see it.
First time, because I never have. Playing classic Mega Man again and stuff like that. Or it could be a chill stream, like what I did on my birthday, where we do various segments. That
also, he presents like 9 options.
Gameplay. and instead could be just kind of relaxing and interacting, maybe do a tier maker or two.
No one is going to respond. DSP. All right, I have to pause the game and go full screen Phil and pause him cuz I need to derail. I was trying not to get derailed from the game. But DSP, dude, no one is going to tell you what they want if you give them 9 options. You have to give them 3 or 4 options and then go. I studied communications and research methods in college. When you're surveying a community for feedback, you give them 2 to 4 options and you say it's this and it's this and it's this. You pull them once, you give a set amount of time for the results to come in and be tabulated, and then you program for yourself and you decide. He sits here just stalling and saying, oh, we could do one of these 9 things. He doesn't actually want to do any of those 9 things. He's just saying those 9 things so he can act like he's kind of busy and he can stall. And it's so annoying because we all do better streams than him. We all do. Lefty, Indrid, Snood, me, everybody. We all do better streams and we program our own fucking shit at like a moment's notice. This makes me so upset. We have less than he does. We all make less money than he does. Okay, that's just a minor derail. But I hate when he talks like this. It makes me so upset.
Because you know, usually that it'll start around noonish, like 12:45, and go all the way to like 7 p.m. What game would you want to see me play for like 7-8 hours in a day, right? Could there be a challenge run or something that you want to see me do in a game that you've seen me play before?
All right, we'll go back to the game because Phil sucks. Here we go.
Would you like to see a retrospective where maybe we go down memory lane?
Oh my god.
We relax and watch some of my old stuff from back in the day and I react to it.
I actually want to watch him watch his old shit because he cringes.
So
he gets cringe as fuck on all of his old shit and it's that stuff is fascinating to watch.
Essentially by either the end of this month or the first week of May. We need to lock.
Oh my god. If he does it, okay, so I'm taking the day off May 4th. If he does it on May 4th, well, I'm already going to stream whatever he does all day. That's my plan. I'm going to do an all-day DSP stream. I'm going to go from the pre-stream to the end of the night stream straight. And I'm going to play Jedi Fallen Orders.
Natsune says, what about a retro game like Nintendo 64's GoldenEye on the Switch?
Yes, Green Mountain. I am familiar with that TED talk. Malcolm Gladwell has done great work in terms of like how people think and how you should deal with feedback. And Phil does the opposite of all of that.
Anyway,
you're correct. Raziel the Lost. Lefty and I were on Profit true? Stream last night, and that's the topic that came up. The Street Fighter 2 demo was out the other day. Phil could have played it, but he chose to do nothing, and his audience told him he wanted to do it. Yes, Tran. I mean Survivor, Jedi Survivor. I'm going to be playing that, so it's going to be similar to this layout, and I'm just going to be playing. So this was kind of a test for that. Because I just want to do like an all-day stream where it's just my game in one box, Phil's chat in another box, and then Jedi Survivor in the other box. So if anybody wants to hang out and watch Jedi Survivor, May the 4th be with you. I'll be streaming it all day on May 4th. So be there.
It's a special event here for DSP Gaming, okay? So there you go.
You know what? I am one of the few people that I know that I'm down for Star Wars and Star Trek. I appreciate both. The child in me loves Star Wars because Star Wars is for kids, but the thinking man in me loves Star Trek because Star Trek is for mature adults who think.
I don't even know.
And you know what the weird thing about Phil is? He doesn't like either. He doesn't like either Star Trek and Star Wars, and I do not fucking get that.
We're doing internet history, and that's what won the poll.
Oh, Chem Bomb.
Okay, so, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for being here and chilling with me on the podcast. As you know, I'm a
I'm going to swap this for this.
That I get primarily on my
stream. Okay, although, I got to derail again. Hold on, we're going full screen. We're going full screen, Phil.
It's contributions.
Phil!
Super chats, super stickers, memberships, gifted memberships.
Phil, you are not a crowdfunded individual. You're a beggar. Crowdfunding has an endpoint. A crowdfunding campaign, because I've done these, again, I did this shit in college. A crowdfunding campaign says, I want to buy or do X. I need a set amount of dollars and cents to buy or do X. I will have this amount of time to procure and gather funds to buy or do X. Will you help me? And then at the end of that point, you either give everybody's money back if you don't get the goal, or you do the thing. You can't beg for years saying you are a crowdfunded individual with no endpoint. You are a fucking charity case, DSP. You are not a crowdfunded individual. I've known people who have gone into medical bankruptcy and they've needed crowdfunding campaigns to pay for transplants. They are crowdfunded individuals because we got the money and they got the transplant. You are just a fucking charity case who doesn't manage his money. Okay. Minor derail, but we're going to get back on track in a sec. Thank you, everybody. I'm sorry. Unless if you show up to this for that, then you're welcome.
That's why you don't see paid advertisement segments and shilling and stuff like that on the show, because, you know, you support me enough. And I really, really appreciate that. So that being said...
Oh, well, Lefty, big ups. Thank you for the poll.
That would be tremendous. And
I love that poll, dude.
Well, the way that we do it on Saturday is a little different, okay? So normally... I would be streaming all day here.
That lady's on fire.
On Saturdays, we have
or that dude's on fire. Holy shit.
Switch over to DSP React.
All right,
DSP
I got a
the internet show. Because of that, what you see on the leaderboard will stay on the leaderboard.
Oh, I know. So I know. Hold on. I know what I can do.
Our running tips goal will stay when I switch
I think
over
I can do this.
Screen. It's not going to reset itself for anything.
Yes! Oh my god, that's so cool.
Yes, if we had
I love when stuff works the way you think it should work.
But
I broke the fire extinguisher, it put out the fire.
Carry that over to DSP React.
This game is goated.
It's easier to hit the rewards over there, alright? Just so you know. It's a little different. Every day I usually just do it all on one channel, okay?
Oh my god, yes, Dog's Blade. He doesn't know what a rainy day fund is.
Thanks in advance to anyone who supports.
A rainy day fund is for when things are grim, not when things not. It's not discretionary income. Well, it is, but it's not in the way he thinks it is.
Five people. You need to join the channel.
Rainy day fund is like my fucking car broke down and I need it fixed. That's a rainy day fund.
So please consider it. Please consider becoming a member or maybe gifting memberships to the channel.
No.
Right now we have over 300 viewers.
I will
I'm
not.
Sure there's many people here who would be very happy to accept a gifted membership to the channel if you'd like to support in that way. Okay? So thanks in advance. And I think at this point, rather than sit here and gab about contributions, let's shout out people who have actually contributed as a way of saying thanks, shall we? Fair enough. Okay, let's do it. We start off today with Clyde Baxter, who became a channel member for a second month.
Troll.
Thank you, Clyde Baxter. I appreciate your ongoing.
Wait, hold on. Does anybody know, is Clyde Baxter a real fan or a troll? Because I thought all of the Baxter socks were trolls. He said that yesterday. He literally said anybody with the name Baxter is a troll. And now he's shouting them out.
For you all live, which is very silly, but people seem to like it, so I've been doing
the crowd funds me. Dog explain.
Okay. So thank you to Jason, and if you would like to
Jason.
Wear a silly hat on today's stream, we do that if I hit $100 in tips raised, which we don't always do, but it's nice when we do. It shows, obviously, a hell of a lot of support and appreciation, and I appreciate that, so please consider tipping if you'd like to see me
come
wear
at
a
me,
silly
bro.
Hat of your choice, which will run a poll to determine what that will be. Thank you, Jason, for your super chat of the day, by the way. We have an overnight tip. Which, by the way, we usually always have an overnight tip.
Oh, that was a weird animation.
Internet. And this tip is from Game.
Oh, I got a shovel from that guy.
Let's go ahead and get the
Gamecock. Gamecocker. Hello, Gamecocker. Okay, that closet is rigged.
So thank you very much, Game Tracker, for your ongoing support of DSP versus
the. Okay, Lefty. You think he's the original Baxter and then everyone else is. Everyone else is copying him to troll. Okay. I thought something like that, but I'm not nearly up to speed on my dentology like you and Snoot are. I didn't really get into the dent wrangling. I'm more fixated on what Phil says and how he talks. Like Lord Thunder and I have like hours long conversations about how this guy talks.
And, you know, thinking maybe he chased them around.
That's kind of my obsession.
When I blow these bubbles, Jasper gets like
Jasper.
What they are. So after trying one time, we're like, wow.
He's a cat, dude.
But then one day on a whim, I just happened to have bubbles. I think it was a game that had bubbles in it, so I brought them and blew them on stream. People thought it was funny. And they were like, hey, why don't you do that for a reward? And I was like, all right. But then eventually we equated it with if we hit a certain amount of likes on the stream, which helps this channel for engagement purposes, I would blow some
for engagement purposes.
It's not very complicated, but I still have like...
Hey, everybody, notice how I'm playing a game, listening to Phil, watching Phil, and reading chat at the same time? He should be doing this.
So game tracker, here we go. With a $30 tip.
Like, this is not hard.
On my submission from last
I can do three things at once.
If you'd recorded a video like that in the modern day, you surely would have titled it something like DSP Quadruple Perfects Justin Wall.
Uncommon melee impactor mod. All right, cool.
Okay, maybe that's not exactly your style of video title, even nowadays, but the fact remains, there exists proof on the internet you quadruple perfected Justin.
Looks like a decent PC. It's got USB 3 ports.
Yes, I know I'm making a mod.
Although the front IO makes me think it's old. I always like when you hit these safe rooms, like, could I stay here for a while, you know? That's one of my favorite things in video games, is to, like, hang out and be like, how comfortable would this room be to stay in for a while? And this one would be pretty comfortable. You got water, you got a workbench, and you got a PC.
No one thought that was something serious or important at all. It's silly. You're playing a random-ass fighting game no one's ever heard of called BioFreaks. It's in a random games tournament at a fighting game tournament in the Midwest, and... Again,
BioFreaks.
Seriously, it's just funny. It's just something funny and silly you do.
Well, he is retconning
today,
the bubbles.
You're absolutely right.
Yes.
Someone would film something like that.
Well, it's because
put the video out.
He's
be like, oh my god, someone quadruple.
He's
so-and-so.
He's retconning the bubbles, and he's retconning so much about his fans because he doesn't. He does everything to alter the narrative that. A lot of his fans, the majority of his fans, are either degenerate misfits, mentally challenged or handicapped, or all of the above. So he does so much to say, oh, if you look at my demographics, they're all, you know, everybody's 30s, 40s. No children watch my stream. My audience is discerning. My audience, you know, knows what they want. They have good taste. You know, this, that, or the other thing. Because he doesn't want to admit to himself and he doesn't want to acknowledge to everyone else that his audience is, like, mostly and well and truly dented. And him retconning the bubbles is another example of that. Because the bubbles came about kind of as a joke, but also as an admission that his viewer base is equally trollish and childish. The trolls like us love watching him blow bubbles because he looks like an ass when he does it. And his fans like watching him blow bubbles is because they're childish mentally, you know? Or they're also sneak trolls like us. So that's why he's retconning the bubbles. Okay, only a minor derailment. Let's go.
Player. And it's like, why is that a big deal?
All right, let's see if we can mod up.
I quadruple perfected Justin in Marvel vs. Capcom 2, the game he's always been the best at worldwide. It's not like I quadruple perfected him in a modern Street Fighter. You know, it's not like even I quadruple perfected him in Super Turbo. It's just a random ass game. But people would, I guarantee you, people would go crazy. And would be like, oh my God, look at this, look at that. That's just how the modern internet.
Okay, so I can repair.
All about.
I can repair a weapon and then upgrade it. Okay, I can only upgrade greens.
Views and personal gain. I agree with what you're saying. It's pretty silly.
I'm gonna add a melee impactor because I've never done one of those.
Did I care that I quadruple perfected Justin Wong? No, I did not. In fact, that's not what the video is even titled, right?
Flex. It's just random flex. Let's go back and hear that again.
11. You know, was I a YouTuber? Yes, I was. Did I care that I quadruple perfected Justin Wong?
Did I care that I quadruple perfected Justin Wong?
No, I did not. In fact, that's not what the video is even titled, right?
Sneak flex. Fuck you, Dave. What am I doing? Let's go back to the game. Oh, wait. I have to unpause him.
It's just random games tournament. So most people who ever watched that video would barely even understand that was me quadruple perfecting Justin Wong in a random.
All right, and this is increases damage, decreases.
That's the awesome part about
decreases durability. You know what?
Over the years, they're all archived. We can
I'll fab it
live together and, you know, enjoy the past, which is kind of neat to go back and see those moments.
I'll scrap this.
Those are again my earlier days as a YouTuber. I started essentially 2009, so in 2011.
Oh yeah, he loved it.
Started doing YouTube videos for money. I didn't even start until early 2011 when I partnered with Machinima. So that year was the first year where I was like, well, I'm free to do whatever
I should exhaust my electric machete is what I should actually do. I should exhaust this.
I want at home and upload. You know, I had the freedom of my own life for the first time, really.
I was an adult.
And so I did so many random things that year. I know I went to a lot of tournaments. I went to convention. That was the first year I went
to convention. Okay, I can go downstairs.
If I remember correctly, it was either late 2010 or 2011. When
that's not the way.
To conventions.
I clearly need to go up.
Regular. So, you know, there you go. That's. Thank you for submitting that clip. That was an interesting one. Anyone who wants to submit clips from the past like that.
Or maybe I have to go elevator.
Every week. I'm totally down for that. That's good stuff in my opinion. Okay, entertaining stuff.
In my opinion. Third floor. Again, it's entertaining because he says it is. I hate when he talks like that.
There you go. Good stuff. So that is the shout out so far. Thank you to Clyde Baxter, Jason, and
Thunder. Obviously, you can speak to it because you were there. But like,
that's literally it.
Yes. That was a huge flex at the time, and even now he's using it as a flex. If you have to say it's not a flex, it's a flex.
This is cranberry raspberry flavored seltzer.
I need that fire to go out.
Bad quake. And I like the seltzer water. They're pretty good. Linoli says, did you think about finishing the post-game Pokemon stuff? No. At this point, we're not going back to Pokemon.
I agree. I agree with him on that. The post-game Pokemon stuff is not worth streaming.
Scarlet Violet. I played Scarlet. It was a good playthrough. Certainly the game looked like crap, but the game, you know, was fun to play. Great story. Actually, one of the best stories of a Pokemon game in a long time. But I'm definitely not going back to it now. So, okay. Let's see here.
One what?
Videos
come on.
Today's React? 69. But I did have to take a couple out. I think there's 69 videos that are in the playlist, but I think that it was really like 70-something, and I did have to remove a few of them because they were...
All right, we're going in the ceiling.
...or flagged and stuff like that.
It's just a small, enclosed space with no room to maneuver or breathe. Barely.
Ben, I am a huge fan of books.
I'll agree with the poll that Lefty put up. Star Wars is for man-children and dent-heads, and I am a bit of a man-child in that way. I love Star Wars.
Reptar says, I was wondering if we ever revisit Team Fortress 2.
Star Trek is for mature adults, though.
I don't really think many people care about Team Fortress 2 besides the hardcore community.
TNG is goated. TNG and DS9 are goated.
I really don't think that happens anymore. It's more of like a throwback retro game now, which is fine, but really the best way to play Team Fortress 2...
This game's fucking cool. Phil should be playing it.
It's not possible, so right now it's not really in the cards, I would say. Pickle Man wants to know what kind of question I have for him today. See, let's see.
All right, this machete's almost busted.
How about this? What is your favorite item from 7-Eleven? Let's see what he has to say. If he has an answer, I'm curious. There you go. And there's a reason why I'm asking that question. You guys will see in a bit.
It's one of his reacts. He's going to react to 7-Eleven and he's going to hate it.
Ones when I was younger. A real one? Interestingly enough, when I was first starting on YouTube.
Real 7-Elevens are not that cool. There are way better convenience stores.
Starting on YouTube,
you can get a decent Coke slushie in there, which is a cool thing, but that's like the one thing is that you can buy frozen Coke.
I genuinely wanted to do was possibly do. I know this
claws,
stupid,
dude. I got Wolf. Well, actually, no. I'm gonna wait till I can upgrade those. But I got Wolverine claws.
Like go to a place everyone claims is
haunted.
Not go in there with technology and shit, but just go in there and
hot feet. What is this? Is this porn?
Being there. I don't need a meter. I don't need to do fucking recordings of voices. Just did anything creepy happen?
Oh, hot feet. Okay, opposite of cold feet.
I was genuinely interested in something like that because people have asked me.
Sadie, 7-Eleven is. I don't know if you're being sarcastic, so I'll just explain it. 7-Eleven is. 7-Eleven is an American convenience store that was founded in 1963. Thanks, Derek.
Possibly not how people think of them in a supernatural aspect. Maybe there's a scientific explanation.
7-Eleven's all right.
Reported paranormal activity, and we just don't know the science of it yet. Right? Maybe there is. A way that there's a resonance in places on Earth where people live, and it's a scientific occurrence, and we just don't get it. Right?
So now Phil believes in ghosts.
Or maybe there are real ghosts. I don't know.
Now Phil believes in ghosts. Unbelievable. Unfucking believable, dude.
Any kind of real paranormal experience in my life, but just because I haven't had a paranormal experience doesn't mean it doesn't exist. It just means I haven't had a reason to believe.
Wait!
Right? But I'm an open-minded guy. I don't want to just...
Are you for fucking real right now?
They have had these experiences.
So hold on.
Maybe it's true.
So are you for real right now? He's saying that just because I have not seen a ghost or had a paranormal experience, that doesn't mean it's not true. Meanwhile, he will immediately say, unless someone can prove beyond a shadow of a doubt that I've done something bad, beyond the content that I have published, it didn't happen. How can you say you're willing to believe in ghosts when you also say the trolls that have evidence against me are wrong, even if it comes from my own content? DSP, Phil, my dude, you are the worst person. Oh my God. I can't believe we just got that.
I mean, like, I was actually genuinely curious and open-minded about this. I was like, could I maybe, if I did my own investigation, keep in mind I used to live in Connecticut, and Connecticut used to have a lot of haunted places supposedly you could visit. So maybe I would do like an overnight investigation somewhere with a group of, filmmakers or friends or whatever, and just film our experience in a house or whatever is supposed to be haunted and see what happens. If something crazy happens, If not, report that too. You know what I'm saying? So,
Master Key. Well,
there you go. But, you know, I don't necessarily believe or...
All right, let's upgrade the claws.
So Big Old Man has answered. Says, my favorite item from 7-Eleven is the classic Slurpee. Well, there you go. Me?
What a boring answer. You know what? I'm going to equip the claws. Just to equip them.
But believe it or not, when I first moved out here, they had a special summertime... like Slurpee.
And it was bro just needs to look in the mirror and he'll see a ghost.
And it was
cherry. You're correct. I agree with you.
And it wasn't half bad. It wasn't amazing, but it wasn't that bad at
all. Oh my God.
Like, you know, that was actually
I'm Wolverine.
I don't care what it was,
LeBron. Motherfuckers.
The flavor was pretty good. The truth is I almost never ever eat at 7-Eleven. The most I've ever eaten at 7-Eleven was I used to go over a friend's house at night, and we would play video games, like fighting games, at my friend's house till like 1 in the morning. And then his fiance would kick us out. Okay, fair enough. It's kind of late. We should leave. And then on the way home, there'd be a 7-Eleven that we would stop at. And since it was overnight...
Notice how when Phil was...
overnight. And we would go to the guy at the front
counter. Notice how when Phil was like 26 or whatever, he had friends that had fiancés, and he didn't. And he played video games and drank all night. Notice that.
So he'd make something instead of nothing.
I agree, Reap. AMPM, way better than 7-Eleven.
There you go.
Way better. I have a couple of those by me. And they're okay.
So there you have it. That's my 7-Eleven
story. Unlock the ballroom.
Jason did another super chat saying I was.
I need to get down.
I don't want to talk about it. Well, Jason, here's the thing. There is a lot of stories.
Oh, you know what? I need to do this.
I don't even know if it's ever been proven that it was aliens that did it. But there's a lot of stories like that, and there doesn't seem to be a logical explanation for some of them. Is there something behind them? I'm open-minded. I'm not going to say
there we go.
No. Every person who's telling that story is lying. Why would they all be? Maybe there's a few who are trying to get notoriety, or maybe they live boring lives and they just want to get noticed, right? But at the time, you have to think that maybe...
Oh, I have. I've eaten at 7-Eleven. Watch out for their hot dogs, dude.
Lying in there that it started on, that all the bullshit got piled on top of. So, you know, maybe you were abducted, and if you were, that should be maybe a story that should be analyzed and told at some point. Thank you for the super chat. Okay. Happy Saturday to you, Derek. Says you can't wait to see what's on DSP versus DSP.
Derek has arrived.
All right, I can already tell you.
Yes.
Stream, I see a drunk guy.
I hear you.
Some more food exploration.
Did you hear
looks like a British comedy video. A stand-up comedian. And a gameplay. A clip of gameplay that's supposed to be funny. And that's just the first few videos.
I was anyway.
Right.
AMPM's cool. They've got a couple in New York over by me. There's one or two of them in Connecticut that I knew of too. But they're a way better convenience store.
Ryan Wilson says, "What difficulty are you playing the Star Wars Jedi Survivor?" Probably standard. Whatever the standard difficulty is, just like
the champ is here. That's right, Sadie.
I replayed BioShock 1. Okay, when the remaster collection came out, I replayed it. and
I need you. You have to get here.
I would like to one day replay.
Ah!
BioShock Infinite. Okay, but I have not replayed.
It's Cat Burnell.
So maybe that's
something. Cat Burnell is here.
I do own the HD collection digitally.
It's actually Cat Burnell.
Linuli says, "Will you sell my submission in time? We ran out of time last night." Yeah, I don't know. Linuli, again, I don't know. I just, whatever it was. Again, with the standard members, when it comes to DSP versus the internet, it's first come, first serve. I'm going to commit to you guys now that I'm always going to post up the threads where you will be posting up your video nominations on Sunday nights. So if you're a member on DSP Reacts and you're like, when is Phil going to post up the threads so we can nominate videos? Sunday nights. I'm always going to do it after my late stream on Sunday. Since I'm going to do it consistently, it'll be first come, first serve. It'll be fair for people to be, oh, I know when he's going to do it. Let's jump on and post up our videos right away and try to get in there. So, again, 69 videos in the playlist. We'll see how many we get to today. I don't know what order people, you know, post it up. First come, first serve. I did it chronologically.
These claws are pretty cool.
Really? Derek is saying, I actually did a DSP tries it on that LeBron James sprite and I hated it. Am I misremembering then? Wait a minute. You're saying it was LeBron James sprite. I thought it was one of the icy drinks. Wait a minute. The LeBron James sprite, was that not actually a bottle of sprite? That was not the drink, the icy drink, right? I think they're two different products we're talking about. Excuse me. Jason says, how do you nominate videos? Okay, you don't do it on DSP Gaming. This is our gaming channel. The channel is DSP React. You know, I think...
See, but this is your problem, DSP. You talk about your other channel so much on this channel that, like, no one knows what to do. Right? Like, that's your problem.
I'm going to head over to DSP Reacts, and on the community tab of that channel, I'm going to post up threads. So depending on the level of member you are, ultra members are going to have a thread where they're guaranteed...
I'm trying to find, like, environmental stuff. It doesn't seem like there's a lot of environmental stuff I can use.
For sure. And you can nominate two videos.
Okay, there's a loose wire here.
So when that thread goes live...
That's not bad.
If you're subscribed to the channel, which I'm assuming you are, right? You're going to get a notification. It's going to say, hey, you know, DSP Reacts has posted up a community post. Go check it out. So you're going to want to go there as soon as you can and post up your two nominations. First come, first serve. That's how it works.
All right, okay. These claws aren't doing it.
Yeah, see, Derek, that's different. He says it was March 21st, 2015. A LeBron James limited edition sprite. That's not it. That's not the sprite. That's a bottle of sprite that I did later. I was talking about an actual, like, icy, slurpy flavor that they had at 7-Eleven. I think it was the first summer I moved here. It was actually a really hot summer day, and I was driving around, and I stopped and grabbed it. I'm pretty sure.
All right, she's almost done.
Lady Charisma says, are the comments in the order when they were posted, or is it a different order? No. They're chronological. I sort the comments in chronological order, so it literally is first come, first serve. And then I review each video. Literally, I just open the link. It's going to play. If it plays and it doesn't get flagged for something, and I'll play it for, like, maybe 5 seconds, and just to make sure it's fine and everything, and then I add it to the playlist. Okay? So I don't really know the full context of any of the videos. I just know, in general, what the context of the video will be from the title and just the first couple seconds. That's it. And then I add it. Okay? So it literally is fair first come, first serve. Those who post first will get on the show first. You see? Okay. Let's see here. I received a $5 tip from Super Snow Carl Turbo HD Remix. Thank you very much, Super Snow Carl Turbo HD Remix, for the $5 tip. And they said the following. Why aren't you going to play the new upcoming Nintendo Switch release Advance Wars if you're not in a strategy-based game? Well, we talked about it. And yeah, I really don't feel...
Oh my god.
That
was rough.
Strategy-based games...
It worked.
...are really going to work out well for the channel.
Dead Island 2, base game is 60. If you want everything, it's 80. Including, like,
right?
extra skins and whatever's for the season pass. I bought the $80 one because my friend Steve really loves the Dead Island games, and we're gonna play everything there is co-op. So I bought the $80 one because I think it's worth it for me, but base game is $60 on PC anyway. Right? On Epic Game Store.
So playing those kind of games, you have to commit to a lot of time. And right now, it's chloroform. I just committed to extending the Oblivion playthrough with this Shivering Isles DLC.
All right, just want to make sure I didn't miss anything.
In playing Final Fantasy V Pixel Remasters, and now we're playing, Part 5.
I feel like I did that the hard way.
So basically, there's other things I'm just way more interested in. There's no opportunity right now.
Because there was, there was water I could have used.
As a daytime stream. I think that absolutely
but whatever.
Would have to be a late night chill stream. And I don't see that working right now with everything else we have going on. So that's why. There's a lot of factors to consider there. Okay?
A lot of factors. All right, I'm gonna full screen fill for you guys for a minute. I have to go get a drink because I'm thirsty. I'll be right back. But you can hang out with Phil without me. Make sure he doesn't touch you anywhere.
And you keep adding videos. Well, here's why, Escanor. There's a couple reasons. Number one, because the Ultra members are guaranteed to have their videos watched every week on DSP versus the Internet. So that wouldn't even work. Because the Ultra members have to be watched first. So I need a new playlist every week. You see, that's number one. Number two, if that happened, I did it like that. What would end up happening is we would have an endless backlog of videos, and mostly the videos would always be outdated. So I'll give you some examples here. There have been times that we've watched a video that's pertinent to something going on. We watched a couple videos that were holiday related, right? Themed. Imagine if we're 3-4 months backlogged on videos, and someone submits a video of fireworks for 4th of July, and it's October.
Ah, my lady's getting attacked.
Right?
This game doesn't actually pause. This game doesn't actually pause.
It's the only way to get active participation.
I didn't realize this game doesn't actually pause when you hit start. Ah! I almost died.
Right? What's the incentive to want
to
submit new
videos?
You'll have no incentive. You'll have people, one week we'll have someone submitting 200 videos, and the next week I'll get zero submissions and nothing fresh. Right? It doesn't work like that. Plus, let's be honest, there's new movies, new things that come out, people want to react to that. So you know what I'm saying? So
it doesn't work because you set it up incorrectly from the beginning, Phil.
It's timely, it's fresh, and there is competition to get your videos down.
If you had ways to communicate with your community outside of the channel, such as Reddit, Twitter, or Discord, you could do all this shit there.
It has to be something refreshed every week.
But it's so fucking loosey-goosey with who sends what and whatever. It's just Derek that sends everything.
He believes it was called Sprite 6 Mix. It was by LeBron James, Slurpee Combinations. It had the traditional taste of cherry and orange.
Okay, military career key. Okay.
That makes sense, because remember I told you to taste like cherry and Sprite?
So there are special boxes.
Okay, kind of makes sense.
I did nothing wrong.
I liked that flavor. Lily says, did you get used to the 60 frames per second? Now the new console is faster. I think most games, I have gotten used to 60 frames, and I'm really enjoying it.
Hey, Phil, you know how you get 60 frames a second all the time? Play on a PC. Just play on a PC. And it's always 60 frames per second. Play on a PC.
Which Comic-Con, by the way?
Nothing wrong with consoles. I also own consoles. I have an Xbox and I have a PS5. Like, I play on those too. But for streaming, nothing is better than PC. And that's a fact. That's an actual fact.
If you watch a new movie or game trailer, you should clip it as a video. People like watching others react to a trailer. Well, the thing is, you're talking essentially like something that should be a short, but the short doesn't really work for a reaction.
No, that's not what they said. Like they're saying video. If it's 2 minutes, just put those 2 minutes up. I agree. That's good advice, actually.
We'll see. I haven't really reacted to anything new recently, have I? I don't think so. We'll see.
Let's open up the map.
Arkham, it's all good. You never.
Whoa, this map is weird.
Jade says, I love to see...
Oh, okay, so we have the district, and then we have all of LA. Okay, so they're like... They're medium-sized sandboxes. It's not one open-world map. Okay.
That's neat. Gotcha. JDTV says, how do I do special moves in Street Fighter 2 Turbo on the SNES? I played it today, I suck at it. Look them up. Look up a moves list, and you gotta mess with it. It's hard. It's actually... genuinely tough.
Now, guys, do you think he's telling him to look it up because he's just being an asshole, or do you think he genuinely doesn't know? Do you think he genuinely doesn't remember how to do it? And then trying to do it on like I think pad. He doesn't remember how to do it.
That was hard back in the day, so
I think he actually doesn't remember how to do it.
Two versions, World Warrior and then Hyper Fighting, both on SNES, on a SNES pad, using the shoulder buttons and stuff. Imagine, I was trying to do spinning clothesline, and you had to press the shoulders and stuff, like, you had to go like this, like crazy button combinations to get the moves to come out. It was pretty nuts. Yes, Derek, it does look like your membership did run out here on the channel. If someone were to gift any memberships today, Derek would likely be at the top of that pile because he is a regular attendee.
Oh my god, no one's gonna gift because people don't want to give. People. My guy, your community hates Derek. Your community actually hates Derek. Derek getting a membership is disincentive for people giving memberships. How does he not know that?
There's gonna be Street Fighter Cross Tekken.
How does he not know that?
And Tekken Cross Street Fighter.
His community hates Derek.
Each other's characters. The Capcom version came out first and flopped so horridly that Bandai Namco dropped the entire.
DSP is objectively the only person in his community who likes Derek.
The Capcom side was such a failure, a huge miserable fail, that Bandai just said, "Nah, we're not wasting time and resources on this. Forget it." And what ended up happening as a result, Akuma ended up being a guest character in Tekken 7, which originally was not the idea. The idea was it was going to be the whole cast of Street Fighter characters, but they changed their idea. So there you go. Oh yeah, Derek is going to see the Super Mario Brothers movie tomorrow. Let us know what you think. At this point, everyone will see it before me, and I don't even know if I'm ever going to see it.
You're making a choice not to see it. You're choosing to be left out, Dave.
Excuse me.
And it's such an easy fucking slam dunk for him to just see the Mario Brothers movie and talk about it. It's so easy, dude. No one's, by the time he does his DSP reacts to the Mario Brothers movie, no one's gonna care.
I guess I gotta put up with it.
It's gonna be the Joker movie all over again.
They're still forecasting that next weekend it's gonna be in the 80s, so I guess I really need to get those filters on my day off, and I need to put in the air conditioners. Hooey.
Hoy.
Thank you, Derek. This is a nice water shirt. Thank you. Mushroom Kingdom
Pizza. Oh, I think I know what to do. I think I know how to.
There's a Columbia Comic Con June 9th, says Juan Ortega. Interesting. Interesting. Okay. Give me 1 second. My leg is feeling a little. Ah, yeah. Ooh.
How do I unlock this door? Or can I cheese it and get in?
I'm getting old. I'm going to have to start getting up and walking around a bit.
It's locked by a mag lock. I thought I disabled the mag lock. I'm not gonna throw another thing in here. I looted the locker. I'm not gonna throw another item in there to lose it. Yeah, Lord Thunder, it is 2 years away. It's like obviously 2 years away.
Let me tell you guys.
You're not old!
Okay, what happened?
You're no, 41 is not
Jason
old.
Just gifted 5 memberships to the channel. Thank you, Jason, for your support of DSP Gaming.
Fuck you, Jason.
Derek got the first one, just like I said. JDTV, Average Doge Waifu, Nico, and Raphael Mato. So congratulations to all 5 of you. Please be sure to thank Jason for his generosity and the support of the community. And, of course, thank you very much, Jason, for your generosity and your support of the community. Because of that, we kind of hit the goal that I had for today, 575. I mean, I'll just increase this arbitrarily now. Because obviously you always want
oh my,
to more growth.
He just called it out. He just called it out. That his goal increases are arbitrary. Big ups, Dents. Big ups, Dents. Hey, Barrett, how are you?
Argum, no, I don't know anything about a guy paying $10 million and going to jail for 40 months with Nintendo. I have no idea. I typed 560. Oops. Supposed to say 580, obviously it's supposed to say 580, right? Oops, there we go. Thank you for correcting me, appreciate that. You guys got to check my work, or else I'm going to submit it to the teacher. I'm going to flunk.
You should have flunked. You're flunking streaming, dude.
Getting a Steam Deck and stream a PC game. I did think about it when it first came out. Remember?
No.
And we talked about it. And it's
like, none of the games on the Steam Deck are gonna be shit. He's gonna want.
Like basically, you're kind of limiting yourself if you do that. Because it's
that's not true though. A lot of cool shit runs on the Steam Deck. It's just not.
Really pricing and availability.
It's not.
They're still not available to just buy. Right?
Yes, they are.
On a waiting list.
No.
And then when they're, it's
no.
Like the PS5.
Dude.
Right? You're on a waiting list.
I was in Best Buy.
Say, okay, it's available.
I was in Best Buy last week, and they had Steam Decks.
Those funds, and I don't have.
They're there. You know, they're there, dude.
Sit on a waiting list for it. You know what I mean? So.
Steam Decks are fucking everywhere.
Yeah, I haven't really seriously considered it. Hobo X says the Nintendo lawsuit was huge news. It's an insanely overbearing punishment pushed by Nintendo in the courts. What is it? What was it? I don't know what it is.
Rev Gamer, all right, I'm going back to the claws for now.
React series so far. Why is it the mini mall rap? The mini mall rap was funny. It was good. That guy was seriously good.
Hey, Decepticron.
Rapping and. He was a good advertiser for, or a good advertisement for his store.
Lefty, stop attacking the boyfriends.
Paid to do that, right?
This is the type of infighting that Phil wants.
Comparison videos, some of the fail stuff.
It builds the narrative that we're striking each other. Stop the violence, Decepticron.
The Arnold advertisements was hilarious. There's been a lot of stuff in the last, you know, two and a half months. Felix, I don't even remember that.
Oh, that's a goated animation.
Played it the one time. Literally says you cannot really play any new releases at any good settings in Steam Deck.
Through the head? That's a great animation.
Lady Charisma says it's a great emulation system, essentially.
Yeah, it is. It's a good emulation system. So is the Xbox Series S.
But resellers are ended up selling for $1,200 or more because so much demand. Damn. That's crazy, right? That's really crazy.
Okay, it's another version of the cat that we fought earlier.
Oh yeah, Jade's seasonal allergies are bothering him too, yeah. Mine are just right now starting to act up. I can tell, you know, when you wake up, my throat's swollen.
I need to find an environmental to get this guy with.
About, right? It happened. Pretty soon, I'm probably going to have to start taking regular allergy medicine. It happens every year.
It's water.
So.
I'm pretty weak. Decepticron, that's what happens when you come into our house and you insult one of the boyfriends. Get gouted by Lefty.
Okay. Let's see here. There's apparently going to be a different competitor to Steam Deck called Asus ROG Ally. What the hell kind of name is that?
ROG handhelds have been around for a while. Shows how out of the loop he is, but ROG has been making those for a bit.
And taught her how to rap. However, the flea market in Montgomery no longer exists. That sucks. They went out of business, huh? Does Cat watch these pieces of the internet? She does. Not the whole show, so she tunes into the show usually to watch some of it and see what's going on. I don't think she watches the whole thing. She watches parts of it. I haven't thought about Dark Side of the Ring documentaries because
oh, come on.
Wrestling just seems to be so intensely claimed on YouTube and is a huge issue on YouTube for some odd reason.
Barrett, it's great because he's been drinking his own piss for so many years that like the gaslighters know exactly what to say to him to bait him into believing the dumbest shit.
It just has so many issues. Like, one of the few streams I ever had of gameplay that ever got taken down was WWE 2K because it had a wrestling clip in it. So I try not to mess around.
I try not to mess around.
Energetic, running around the house. I have no idea who the Island Boys are. Any upgrades to the room coming in the future? Realistically, when you think about the upgrades that we've done in the last 6 months,
gotta just chip this dude down.
Right? lighting upgrade. Holy shit, what a difference.
The lighting's not an upgrade. The lighting is like a noticeable downgrade.
Formal border for the podcast, right? We've had so many improvements. I mean, realistically, what would be more improvements for the room? Better lighting.
A PC, dude. Like a PC.
So, honestly, the only
game on a PC, dude.
That might be an upgrade. Would be a green screen. Now, I haven't looked into that.
You don't need a green screen.
Why? Because people tell me I really like the setup behind
you. You don't need a green screen. You don't.
Intrusive. So there really hasn't been a need for a green
screen. If you got a new PC with a 2060 card or above, and it's not that hard to get a 2060 these days, you could use NVIDIA Broadcast Background Remover. Oh, this fucking guy. This lady doesn't hit hard enough.
All this shit out. There's no other way to do it, so there'd be no decorations if I have a green screen. So I don't know.
So many upgrades. That's right, Sadie.
Liking these alternating decorations every month, and maybe that's more important than having the green screen for certain playthroughs, right? Keep in mind, the vast majority of people who use a green screen don't have a nice setup like this. They just sit at a computer desk.
That's not a nice setup. That's not a nice setup.
You know?
Oh my God, he thinks his setup is a nice setup.
Something nice behind me, you know?
That's not a nice setup.
Lulu said the Steam Deck's performance is a bit better than a baseline PS4. So you can understand it cannot
run
games with good settings.
Are you kidding me? No. 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 The Steam Deck is way better than a baseline PS4. What the fuck are you talking about? My phone is better than a baseline PS4.
For a while, is it better watching videos for DSP versus the internet than your old TV? I don't think that the TV's quality would impact watching YouTube videos. I think it impacts gameplay. For gameplay, yes. It's the least input delay I've ever experienced on any television I've ever owned. The colors are absolutely gorgeous on this thing, too. It's a really, really nice TV. I'm actually very excited to start experiencing all the new slew of games like Jedi and Redfall and Zelda and Street Fighter and you know, Diablo and more, you know, Final Fantasy, all these new games coming out in the next 2-3 months. It's going to be really cool to be playing on essentially a modern TV with nice colors and everything like that. You know, my TV before this was a discount TV, a TCL. That's why it died within only a few years. The one before that was a nice TV. It was an LG, but it was a very outdated model that over the years, you know, wasn't performing well anymore. This one is really, really sweet. So, yeah, I'm really enjoying my new TV. Even though it's not really new anymore. I got it in, what, October? So. Let's see here.
I'm just cheesing this dude.
Let's see, we've got...
I know his pattern.
Have I thought about reacting to Internet AJ's machinima history? Considering you have insight and a long partnership with them, I don't know what that is. A year or two ago.
Well, he dropped a lot of shit.
Looking on the internet to see
okay, now we can move on.
An in-depth documentary about the history of machinima, and no one really had. The only video I could find, someone talked about...
Yeah, he does not improve his streams. We improve our streams in the detractor community on a near daily basis.
Over the years, where people became a partner with Machinima.
I just purchased $3,500 worth of PC components to improve the streams. And this is a fucking hobby. Alright. We improve the streams.
And that was a big thing with Machinima. People were pissed off about this. They were like, we don't want to be locked into all these multi-year contracts, but Machinima was doing this, and basically people didn't know what they were signing. Then there was also the controversy where Machinima did a big sponsorship campaign.
Okay, so the majority of people in our chat have eaten at 7-Eleven.
Sponsorship campaign. So people under Machinima were doing all these paid-for videos, but they weren't presented as paid-for videos. And that's illegal. You actually cannot do a paid advertisement campaign without disclosing it to that. It violates the law. And Machinima blatantly violated the law and had to...
That's not true in all cases.
I saw... a documentary about that, like that aspect of it. I never have seen a documentary about the actual history.
It doesn't violate the law, but it's considered an unfair business practice. There is a difference.
So much insight because I dealt with them for an incredibly long time, 2011 all the way through 2017, over 6 years, when most people were telling me leave Machinima, no one likes them, they're not trustworthy, they're changing as a company. You're one of the legacy people who's still with them. Everyone has left Machinima and went to other companies. Why don't you? And I was like, you know, I never really had too many problems with them. But man, do they have a weird ass history. As I've said over the years, the way that they treated me was very different depending on who was in charge and what programs they were running and stuff like that. They would get financing and all of a sudden they would expand and start giving people free games and trips. And then all of a sudden their financing would
out. Dave, you're surprised that a change in management would dictate a change in your treatment. That's how business literally works.
Feel like that would be an interesting thing for me.
I work at a large corporation. Whenever there is a management change at the top, it flows downhill to everybody.
Anyone has ever done an in-depth history of the
You know That's just how business works. He would know that if he was actually a businessman with a business degree.
Reactions. Reaction. Wow.
7-Eleven is trash food, but sometimes you just need a slushie.
Yeah, interestingly enough, someone the other day on one of the
Savvy in the butt.
You should go and re-react to your Down the Rabbit Hole documentary. And I was like, what? Re-react? What can I do a year later? That's gonna be different than the first one. Like, what are you even talking about? I was like, huh?
Huh?
What are you speaking of?
Huh? So he brings up this anecdote of a message he received just so he can shit on someone. Excuse me.
Okay.
You know what? I'm just gonna run.
Did I ever run on a track, like a track meet thing? No, I actually never did.
I'm just gonna run.
And our gym classes in high school didn't use the track. Hey, interestingly enough, they didn't use the track.
Ah, good. Finally, some life.
Try and I agree. A slice for a dollar isn't bad, but I've been to some $1 pizza places in the city that are fucking goated. Some of the best pizza slices I've had in my life have been $1 slices on the street in New York City.
And then we get ready for DSP versus the internet over on DSP Reacts, just so everybody knows, okay?
Can you search the front? You find that girl, you bring her around back, and we'll straighten this thing out. Just watch out for the other.
Well, I was an only child, Arkham, but I live with my sister. Well, I should say this. My sister lives with us, my family. My sister, oh my god, let's try this again. I don't know, my brain is like scrambled today. Let's try this again.
Good question, Lefty, in the chat about the React content.
My parents were
Melissa Story, let's fucking go.
There you go. The bad news. Good lord. I don't know how I botched that one so badly.
Because of your gin brain.
For React content coming up on DSP.
Because of your actual gin brain.
I'm going to do a retrospective video on the history of Harry Potter movies. I've seen all 8 movies in the last month now, and I'd like to do a video.
Says the man who has no time. But he watched 8 fucking movies. He watched 12 hours of content. But he has no time. Okay. Okay, my friend.
Why? Because they just announced the sequel to Godzilla vs. Kong, so it makes sense to watch and review the first one now. Super Unknown, we beat Silent Hill 3. Super Unknown says, you should drop Silent Hill 3 and play Mega Man Battle Network. We beat Silent Hill 3. And there's no time for Mega Man Battle Network. We got Star Wars coming out Friday, so. No, I never rode in a horse and carriage. Yes, my family, apparently, my grandfather's side of the family came from Foggia, Italy. F-O-G-G-I-A. Foggia or Foggia, I don't know how to pronounce it.
Foggia. Foggia.
I'm originally from Lecce. L-E-C-C-E. Ever heard
of that? No, Lecce. I used to, Lecce.
Actual Italian restaurant.
Come on.
In Connecticut. A lot of times the
I had an actual Italian grandmother, or I have an actual Italian grandmother. She's 97. So, I know some of these words.
I think Lecce I've seen on there. Yeah, I think I've seen that.
Lecce.
I think Peter Jackson's King Kong was good. I liked it. I thought it was a good movie.
But there's a doctor in Santa Monica. We gotta get going. We? What's this we? My blood is the key to fixing all this crazy shit. Humanity's the
dead air.
Really?
That's why I'm just gonna play games when I watch Phil.
I think people would be interested in the history of Machinima itself. Not
it makes him tolerable.
No, that's the point. I'm hoping Someone will make a factual documentary about the history of machinima, because then I can add in my own experiences dealing with them over the years, and maybe those experiences would make sense if we had a factual documentary to follow along. Like perhaps, oh, in this year, the company had an internal shakeup. The management shifted around, these people, you know, they lost financing. Maybe that would make sense why their attitude towards me changed 1 year versus another. You see? And we could put perspective. That's exactly what I would like to do. I don't think me just sitting here and saying, oh, let's do a 4-hour video where I just talk about machinima over the years. That's just going to be my one perspective. But if there was a long form react about them somewhere, or a long form documentary where I could react to them,
No. Dogsplain, there is one character from Dead Island 1 that I've seen in this game, and it's not that lady.
The controversy that they wouldn't...
I don't want to spoil it. I mean, they might show up. They might just be in the house, but there is one of the prominent main characters from Dead Island 1 that is here. And it's really cool to see them here.
...stories of a partnership network that was ginormous and then went out of business. So... A couple more
nice mic punch. Good job, Phil. I'm going to take a drink because I wanted to take a drink.
Nipple shit.
We're gonna full screen Phil for a bit.
Beef. Like the beef I had with Hutch was in 2010. It was from a misunderstanding. Between the two of us, kind of misunderstanding each other. We actually talked privately, got over it, squashed it, and that's when Hutch got me essentially.
Here, I can boost Phil a little bit.
Real interaction we ever had.
There we go.
That was it. So no, there hasn't been beef with me and Hutch since 2010. It's been 13 years.
Ha ha ha! So, guys,
let's see here.
Lord Thunder, you'll like this. That nervous laugh right after he said there hasn't been a beef with me and Hutch in like over 10 years or whatever. That means he's full of shit. Because that was a, what do they call it? That the laugh is a release of nervous energy. It's called a self-soothe in the world of communications. Here, let's listen to that again.
So, no, there hasn't been beef with me and Hutch since 2010. It's been 13 years.
Yeah, he's coping. He's coping. That is an obvious stress release and a cope in the world of communication. So there's something he's not telling us. Thunder, you and I let's have a conversation about this in the Discord after this, because I really want to try and figure out what the beef is, because there's Hutch videos out there that talk about DSP, and we should find them. Exactly, anxiety lap BST. 100%.
I got another tip from Ray. Says, would you consider bringing back cooking shows?
That's right. I got a drink now. Clank, 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 clank.
No,
it's just cherry soda. I'm not drinking. It's just cherry soda, but it is refreshing.
Changed her mind. So it's only been that way since 2018. You would think by now, 5 years later, you guys would have gotten used to it. I'm really baffled that you guys still bring this up.
You fucking asshole. They're interested in your wife. They want to know your wife.
I've never seen 90 Day Fiancé. And ladies and gentlemen,
he's like a teacher that hates kids. Right. You know what I'm talking about? Everyone growing up had that old teacher that fucking hated children. This is him. This is him. Mr. Burnell hates the children he is in charge of wrangling. He hates them. And it's so obvious. He is just waiting for retirement. But guess what, Phil? There is no retirement for you. You are going to perish on stream, my guy.
Excuse me. Sorry about the burp.
Disgusting.
I don't know who Joseph Anderson is, Ramrod.
Okay, no, but you know who Joseph Anderson is. There's a YouTuber called Joseph Anderson. He does like 9-hour retrospectives on games. He's very good. Phil knows who he is. He's mentioned him before. He just likes shitting on people for bad spelling. Fuck off, Phil.
Indeed, there is always wacky stuff to watch on DSP versus the Internet. It's
Cat needs her dose of ivermectin.
I like the random nature of the show because you don't know what's going to be coming up on the show ever. You never know what to expect, right?
Excuse me.
What's a game I want to play, but people don't seem to ask for it?
Nothing.
A game I would like to play, but people are not asking for it.
Yo, Lord Thunder, this is what we talk about. This is what we talk about every damn day. Thunder, if you're out there. Stalling tactics? Let's watch that again. This is what we talk about every day. Watch.
The show, ever. You never know what to expect, right?
Oh my god, Lord Thunder. Let's talk later. We're gonna have so much to talk about.
What's a game I want to play, but people don't seem to ask for it?
You don't know. You don't know. You actually don't know.
People are not asking for it.
You know?
No, Stray Fox. I disagree with you, Stray Fox. There are no games he wants to play. That's the point of this. He doesn't want to play any game. He's just doing the calculus of what might make him money. He lost his passion for games in like 2011.
Here's the thing. At one point, there was a lot
of
games.
Oh yeah, Thunder.
Like
well,
that.
you and I'll talk later, all right? We're talking later today, my friend.
To play Chrono Trigger right now. Okay, I would not die. That's excessive. I don't want to die.
I'd love to play Chrono Trigger, but it doesn't run on modern consoles. I would have to emulate it, and I don't have a reliable way to emulate it. Prediction.
But I would absolutely love to play Chrono Trigger. And there's just no way to play it on a modern console. It's just not viable. So, that sucks. That's one I've been craving to play. I haven't
Fuck
played
yeah,
Chrono Trigger
I win.
In a decade.
I win.
I believe it. That sucks. That's a game that one of those games, similar to Final Fantasy 4 and 6, where every few years I would like to replay it because it's such a great
exactly,
game.
Exactly, exactly, Emred. Everyone who likes games has a list of stuff they might like in their heads. He should have been able to say, when someone said, "What's a game that you'd like to play that no one asks for?" For me, it's Hitman. I always want to play Hitman, but I've been trying to like diversify to other games. He should be able to say, boom, Hitman, or whatever the fucking game is. Not yawn, stretch, fold his arms, and stall for 15 seconds and not have an answer. He is so far gone at this point. It's kind of sad, but you know what? He deserves it. And his hairline deserves it, too. Holy shit, look at this hairline.
There's no way to do it. It sucks. I wish it was viable, all right?
Phil, you could run and stream Chrono Trigger on your laptop, dude.
I still want to play Lost Odyssey one day, but I almost.
Oh my God, Stray Fox! You fucking called it. Lost Odyssey got mentioned. Big up, Stray Fox.
It's been so long since I've originally played it now that I don't really know if I'd care that much to play it again. I just remember when I played it, I freaking loved it. It was one of the Mistwalker games. The time when Mistwalker.
Oh, Lefty is that going to Decepticon? Here, let's see.
So I probably would enjoy a second run, but. I don't know if it's ever going to happen. I still own the digital rights to it. If we're ever going to play it, but it hasn't happened yet.
Okay, awesome. Yep. We're linked to Decepticon, guys. Guys! We're linked to Decepticon. Thank you, Lefty.
Anyway. JDTV says, I think...
Yeah, you knew it. You were right, Stray Fox.
Those years, I wish we could have lived in an era where we'd be able to go to and play...
You were absolutely right, my friend.
It was very fun. It was very unique. You walk into an arcade, you never know if they're going to have a brand new machine with something new, a new experience you've never seen before, or something groundbreaking when it comes to the way it controls or the way that
it
looks. All
right, we need to wrap this up.
That era,
arcades look since we're not playing a game anymore.
Console games, they absolutely
let's go fast.
We're much better looking at
performance. Let's go.
They were always better.
No.
That was the whole point of the 90s. You go there physically.
Two times speed is a bit hard to listen to. Let's do 1.5.
I took a shit today, says, would you watch Dr. Pimple Popper? I know what Dr. Pimple Popper is. It's a show where a dermatologist literally pops pimples and or treats acne, cysts, rashes, and all kinds of shit, right? And I guess a lot of people find that fascinating. I'm not someone who, I'm not squeamish. So I don't think I would have an issue watching the videos. I just don't know if they would be very
interesting. All right, I think what I'm going to do is I'll keep playing the game, but we'll stay at 1.5.
You know, they think that's gross.
And if you guys want to go over to the Decepticon stream, because there's only a couple minutes left.
Yeah, I know.
But if you guys want to hop over to Decepticon, the link that's pinned, that's fine.
But then there's also more retro barcades that are more indie style. You know, those are independent businesses. Those are cool too. I know. I would probably like to do something like that someday. What are my favorite games in arcades? Obviously, fighting games. I used to like air hockey. I used to like Outrunners, which was a four-player Outrun game where you would race against each other. Yes, Outrun was not just a home game, it was actually an arcade game first. Light gun games like Area 51, super good. Oh, House of the Dead, oh my god, when they went 3D with the light gun games.
Oh, crafting for medkits.
And of course, other fighting games like combat, things cool. like that, and SNK games, that's how I actually played Fighters back in the day. Those were my absolute favorite. Over time, I liked other games, like I played the Bamani games, like Guitar Freak, where you play with guitar, and DDR, yes, I played DDR and other games too, like, there was a few dance games, it wasn't just DDR, there were other
Thank you, BST.
So.
I'm glad you liked it.
Spidey says, I know you don't have a Steam Deck. I'm letting you know you have that option. Steam Deck doesn't have a way.
Yeah, I'm going to, like, walk around until he does his end thing. Right, he puts his stupid, like, Bumblebee thing up.
Yeah, I want Steam Deck. Go online, purchase it, and have
and
it.
And then I'm going to cut this stream, and I'm going to hang out and watch a movie in one of the chat channels on Detractor Beam.
Because
I...
Chrono Trigger. I would love it.
I'm done with Phil for the day. I need to not talk about Phil.
I would definitely not say no.
I caught up on some of the shit yesterday that we played Halo over on Profit Stream. Holy shit. That was a massive spurg yesterday.
I feel like I'm going to get an insane amount of use out of it, so I'm not going to go out there and actively ask for it. If someone was generous and wanted to offer it, that would be different. You understand? Do I ever get tired of talking for hours straight? Yeah, some days I'm done with streaming and my throat hurts. My throat's swollen, and so it happened the last couple days, actually, because these allergies are starting to kick in. It sucks when it happens, but you know, I love being here, but sometimes there's actually physical toll that happens. You know, it's funny because people say radio hosts talk all day. No, they don't. Take a look at a typical radio host and how long they actually talk. They have insanely frequent breaks, right? Even talk radio hosts, they talk for a few hours, they're off the air, right? They got commercial breaks and shit. Like, I talk
Phil,
more than most
if you chose what you said, you wouldn't call, have right? to talk operator, as much.
They take breaks between calls, right? Like, it's pretty crazy. So yeah, my throat, you know, people say, how is it that, you know, you sound so different. We watch your old videos, and your voice sounds
yeah,
so different.
Yeah, if you guys want to hop over to Decepticon, go ahead and hop over.
But honestly, my voice has changed.
He raids us, we raid him.
I talk so much that I
that's just how it works.
My vocal cords scarred them from talking so much. You know, that's just something natural that happens. Excuse me. Okay, guys. As much as I enjoy talking with you, because I absolutely do. This is great.
Yeah, good catch, Barrett. If someone wants to give it to me.
We have to adjourn the show so we can get ready for the React show. So remember, here's what happens.
Let's adjourn.
And when it ends, there will be a link that you can click on to take you over automatically to DSP versus the Internet over on DSP React. You can wait there for a few minutes. I have to change the setup around because I have to change the stream key, I have to change the pop-up, I have to change the logo and everything. It'll take you a few minutes. Then we'll get going over there and we'll get started with the show. Okay? So I hope you guys are excited. I love it. I can't wait to see.
Yes. Yes. Lord Thunder, the vocal strain is real. The vocal strain is real. I've worked it. I've worked at radio and TV stations. I know about vocal strain. I know how to reduce it. One of the ways to reduce it is to not say as much. To literally say fewer words. And he won't do that. Okay. Fuck you, Phil. Alright. Well, I'll full screen the game for a minute. Thank you, everybody, for coming by. I really appreciate it. Consider subbing if you haven't, but hop over to the Decepticon. Really appreciate everybody coming by. Consider giving a like, consider subbing, all that stuff. The boyfriends love you. And I'll probably stream again before then, but my next big thing that I'm planning, my next solo thing, and I'll probably have people come by, is I'm going to be playing Jedi Survivor all day on May the 4th. I took the day off from work, so if you want to come by, it'll be similar to this, but I'll just be playing all day, talking to people. So, big ups, everybody. Thanks for coming by, and I will see you next time. What do I do?